Ah, Scunthorpe. Aside from having a swear word in its name, Scunny's perhaps best known for steelworks. Or what's left of them.
It's not the easiest of places to work, but there's a good laugh. We all got on.
Meet Dean. He used to work on the steelworks. Now he and his family get by on the social. And it's the same for most of the people he knows.
Got no else to do up here but breed and feed, have we?
To survive, they've had to learn how to make their money stretch.
A bit on the side, eh? Chicken fillets, kid.
I'll buy a razor or some links.
The kids have found their own ways to enjoy themselves.
Officers, having a good day!
There's always rough justice when it all gets on top.
Wow, it's a special window, special window.
You're not going to smash no window!
And if you really need a break, you can have one. At Her Majesty's pleasure.
Shoplifting.
It ain't Buckingham Palace, but if you scratch the surface, people are just trying to do the best with what they got. And they haven't got much. For Dean, his wife, and their soon-to-be seven kids, and families just like them round the country, this is what it means to be skint. Since the steelworks started laying off, jobs in Scunny have been harder to come by. Worst hit is the Westcliff estate. Now, not everyone round here is on the dole, but most of the people you'll see hanging around are between jobs, as it were. And if you've nought to do, life here revolves around a wall where everyone sits, called the wall.
Why do people gather here?
Because there's nothing else to do around Westcliff.
So everyone just comes here to chat and just, I don't know, just go to the shop, get a drink, come back here, just chill.
Drink beer, smoke weed.
Socialise. You can get anything at the wall, mate. You can anything. Absolutely.
Class A's to Class C's. It's an illegal shop.
It's an off-licence.
And when they say anything, they mean anything. Today, it's some meat that looks like it's escaped from a local warehouse.
No, do you eat a lot of chicken?
15 quid. You get the more than half price, is it? That's what I thought of your business, isn't it?
We got any left? Pop round, yeah? Yeah.
Cheaper, innit, than the shops? Can't beat it. Back of a car, back of a van, so what? Even chuck the chicken in for now, bless him. Good lad.
Dean's been on the social for a year now, and feeding a family, especially one as big as Dean's, on what the social pays is always a stretch.
Oi! Shut up and get your tea. Both of you. Right. Start here. There's Danny. She's 15, she's my stepdaughter. There's Harry. He's nearly 8. He's my stepson. Leah's 12. She's my stepdaughter. What? James is 16, he's my stepson. There's Latham, 2-year-old, that is my son. There's Alfie, 5-year-old, he's my stepson. And there's Claire, my wife, and this is the next edition.
All right.
They're doing my head in, but I wouldn't change it for the world. That's why I married her. First time I met Claire, I was leaving the pub one night, just paralytic. I just said night Claire to her. She got talking to my mate who was still in the pub. He said, oh, I won't mind meeting him. So he got her on the phone while I was pissed up, just trying to sort a one-night stand out for me because I'd just come out of a relationship and just ended up staying together, and that was just from saying night. Pissed up. I mean, I take after my dad for the drink, obviously, but can't be all bad if I met Claire.
Might just fall out.
That is my only fault, drink. Make sure the kids are sorted first. If I can't afford food for the kids or the bills that paid, I won't buy a drink. I make sure that's done first. All the money in the world, I'm not bothered, I won't change them for the world. None of them. Got no else to do up here but breed and feed, have we?
Often the worst affected when there's little work are the young'uns growing up. Easy to see why you wouldn't bother going to school if you can't see a job at the end of it.
Iron Copper's chasing you.
And that there's more fun to be had being naughty than staying out of trouble.
What's Copper's chasing you?
kids around here will always get into trouble. There's nothing for them to do around here, you know, to stay out of trouble.
They're not all bad, but young Connor is definitely one to keep your eye on.
Fuck the police.
Connor's pretty well known locally. He lives round the corner from Dean with his mum and his little brother.
What are you looking for?
How old were you when you first got excluded from school?
Year 7.
You were year 7. How? What's that?
I'm like 12 or 13, isn't it?
Right. And how old are you now?
15. Been kicked out of 7 schools. Don't go to school. I don't want to go to school. Shit.
I don't know if it's because he's slightly dyslexic, but he's always struggled with his work, which then he gets angry, frustrated, and then he lashes out.
Connor's now supposed to go to a special boarding school for kids with behaviour problems, but he hates having to leave his home and family.
Connor!
Yeah?
Come on!
2 minutes.
You'll be here in 2 minutes. Look at the state of your bedroom.
Whoa! Oh, fucking mad.
I have to go to school for 6 months, like, every day. Weekends and stuff. All week, 7 days. I'm not going to fucking do schoolwork when I'm fucking weekends. My mum fucking makes it about chilling and shit. Fucking stupid. I'm gonna have to go mad.
Just get up. You're taking the mic now. It's 8:15.
Well, go, then.
Well, get up, then.
Go, then. Fuck off. I'm not off to fucking school.
Get up.
I'm not off to school.
Get up.
I'm not off to school.
People are waiting.
Fuck off.
I can't physically get him out of bed. I've tried. But then he just goes absolutely mental. So there's only so much you can do, isn't there?
What?
Give me that phone, then.
No.
Give me the phone. No. Get up.
My phone.
Get up.
Get. We'll move, Dave. Out. What's this?
What are you doing with me?
Fuck off.
Connor, I swear to God, this is the last chance. We've got 2 minutes. When I come back up the stairs again, watch. Get up.
Watch now.
You're going to school.
Fucking idiot.
Thanks. Thanks a lot, Connor.
Smash your fucking...
You what?
Fuck off.
You what?
You both fuck!
Fuck. When times are tough, the black market always thrives. Even if you don't do it yourself, you can sometimes rely on it to make ends meet. Especially when you've got a big brood and a little brother on the dole.
Get out now.
Where are we?
Sorry.
Here, I'll give you it back. Dickhead, bro.
No, I'm not. You just got none of this shit at all. That's why you go over the top when you're here.
Dean, I never go in your stuff when I'm here.
You liar!
I like your fridge, though.
I've got loads of turkey in there because I fucking shoplifted the other day. And bacon.
The joys of knowing smackheads. They are good for one thing, robbing food.
Anyone knocks on that door with cheaper stuff than the supermarkets, mate, I buy it. Too bad. Bernard Matthews, beautiful. Wait on. Do you want any cheese? And I did have 6 packs of them, but I gave Greg 2 to take home with him.
And some carrot cake and a full box of peas.
Carrot cake, it's up. You can box them with bastard tea bags to scram you.
Don't drink fucking tea, you alky, so.
So?
It's easy to find the local shoplifters. There's some who nick to order, and others who just flog whatever they can get their hands on.
He didn't get a graft, I did.
Two of the best-known grafters are Tracy and Mikey.
Some razors and some links. Them and some of them.
How much will you get for them?
tenner a piece on these and a quid each for the links. Dad! Don't want to buy a razor, do you? I'll buy a razor or some links. Nah? How many do you want? Four?
Yeah, but you're going to have to go see if you want
them. Hiya. Avon.
Avon.
Here. Yeah. There you go, look.
Even if I got done, I'd still fucking buy a
phone. Oh, no.
I need to. I couldn't keep my family going on the prices they charge. They all need deodorants, they all need sprays and stuff when they're doing their hair. They're getting to the age where they want to be looking nice.
This is where some like Tracy services come in handy.
Yeah, yeah, she's good with the makeup and the deodorant side and the hair spray.
Straighteners and the fucking curling ones.
Yeah.
The fee from the rich and then man to help the poor, the struggling.
Good lad. Good lad.
Robin Hood style. Except for we're not in Yorkshire, mate, over in Lincolnshire.
Couldn't put it any better, Mikey.
But Sherwood Forest is round the corner that way.
See you later.
Well, that was easy, wasn't it?
Yeah. It's always that easy.
No. No, it is with stuff that people want. Right, now we've got to try and score. And then it's think again where you can get some money from. Snakes and ladders. Up the ladder and down the snake.
Life goes on 24/7 for some people. If you don't have to get up for work, why go to bed? It's the wee small hours, and Dean and the missus are just back from the hospital. She's dropped her seventh, a beautiful baby boy.
My little chunk.
Can't wait for the
BOA, guys. Shyamane, will you go in that fridge? Pass me the milk, please.
Awesome. Tell me who I'm looking at here.
This is Hunter Dean Bell. New edition.
Right.
Just overwhelming. And don't get me crying. Because I'm trying not to now.
Do you know, it's so emotional, isn't he? It's unreal. Danny was baby.
Shut up.
Yeah, the eye fulfilling.
It's black, isn't it?
No,
it's brown. So I don't know him. Have you changed his nappy yet? Well, you get a surprise, he's not like his dad.
Fucking hell, they're massive. And a big willy.
He's got a fucking massive.
Even the midwife who was checking him says, well, he's definitely a boy, isn't he? She even made a joke about it.
Can't be my fucking kid. Nowhere near like mine. Mine are all shriveled up and fucked up.
You won't be able to ask your mum that question.
Yeah, no, you're not going to drive about anyone by now, so.
Connor's upset someone on the estate, and as a result, his mum Jordan has had her windows put through. Lucky for Jordan, Dean's a dab hand at windows.
Fighting, fucking and fucking drinking, that's all they do around here. Yeah. They're both in bed still.
Yeah.
See that?
Yeah.
Start using it.
Yeah, get it
going. Kick them up the fucking arse.
And what do you think your landlord would have said if you'd seen these?
I think he would have asked me to leave. It's happened so many times now.
Yeah. Fucking hell. Fucking beatings. Fucking shit. Fucking screws in the bastard. Fucking spiders. Fucking hell, that's hard work.
Bastard. That way.
Fucking idiot. Don't let it drop, whatever you fucking do. You fucking arsehole.
Well, it's holding now, Greg. It's not rocking, look.
Shut your mouth. Come on, are we all?
Done. Cheers, darling.
Not a problem. See you later, look.
All right, darling.
I'm a bit sweaty. Be careful.
Oh, that's all right, don't worry.
See you later, look.
Tell Claire I said hi.
Pop round for a coffee.
Are you up, Connor?
Yes.
Can you get me a fag?
When Connor does make it out of bed, he ain't on his way to school. And the more time he spends out of school, the more time he spends with his mates.
It's a black bear. Oh, yeah, how much selling it?
Yeah, it's a boulder.
Yeah, well, that's shit, that, innit?
Well, I don't know about it.
How much?
80 quid.
Aye! Fucking idiot.
Do these phones sort of fall into your lap quite often?
What, blackberries? Every day. Every day. Oh, I read all that, it's like, why didn't you say you love me?
She might not be shagging, laugh my arse off. Are you coming? Yes, but not yet. All right, I'll just text my nana again. I'll get her told. No reply. Or laugh my fucking arse off.
How soon would you ever sell that?
Oh, when someone mails me back on Facebook, like, got me on the website going, nana. No, yeah, stuff for sale on Facebook, I swear down.
Really?
Yeah, you sell anything on there.
Robbed pushbacks a lot.
You just got rid of the wrong people and just gone off the rails. Oh, yeah, they've all been to prison already. Yeah. All his friends have all been in and out of prison.
What are you doing?
He's a bit of a follower, Connor, though. He's easily led. Just going to be like all his friends in and out of prison, I think, probably.
Do you want to see that dog pull someone across the floor? Yeah,
I could believe that.
Where's the dog? Where's the dog? Oh, God!
Watch him, mate.
Fucking here, mate.
If you're unemployed and want money, it comes from one of two places, the social or a bit on the side.
Most people just sign on the dole or sell drugs. People get roped into it, don't they? It's an easy thing to do. If you sign on and you ain't got money in that, if you sell drugs, it's an easy way out. It's just sitting on your arse and selling, isn't it?
If you're not into selling drugs, phones or shoplifting, there's just your benefits to get by on. There's people think you're loaded if you're claiming for a big family. The more kids you have, the more money you get, that's for sure. But it still don't go very far.
You don't get rid of a kid just because you're worried about what people are going to fucking think, how much money you get. I've worked 23 years. I think I've earned a bit back off the social. And if they're bothered about me claiming a bit of money, let them fucking say it to my face. Because fucking other people get it for nothing. Other people get it and they haven't even fucking done a year's work in their life, so I couldn't give a fuck what anyone thinks. And that's my honest opinion. I've got to feed my kids at the end of the day and look after my kids. And I'll do anything for my kids. Whether it's legal or illegal. I'm not bothered, I'll say that. There's people who haven't even got a tin of beans in the cupboard. I mean, we're learning to manage. We struggled from July up till Christmas. And now we're just getting into a pattern of getting used to how the money comes in, used to how to pay in the bills, how to make sure we've got enough food in. So I'm used to it now.
But if you have a habit to feed, your benefits are never going to cover it.
I used to be a good shoplifter. I just get caught all the time now.
Why do you think that is?
Because I know who I am. And I take the piss. I go in a shop for the makeup and then they go check the shelf and it's all gone.
You're not very subtle.
No, I don't care. Well, I just take it all. I need to take it all. And then I need to wait for them to stock the shelf back up again. To go back in again. Body shop, I'm banned out of there from getting makeup. Boots, I'm banned out of there for the makeup. I'm banned out of there, I'm known of everywhere.
But when needs must, there's always the street.
They're mostly blowjobs. 15, 20 quid. I slam the car doors if they offer you a tenner. Some of the lasses do everything for a tenner. Need a belt on. Because otherwise, the train go down your trousers when they aren't paid. In the car, in an alley. They pay more if you bring them back to your house. I've come home with 100 quid before, but no, it doesn't last long. I'm lucky if I wake up with any money in the morning.
Where does he go?
On drugs, gambling. And that's it. Oh, here's another one coming down the road. That's the state of the road, it gives it away for a tenner. Yeah, in a minute. Pop straight.
To try to keep the real troublemakers off the street, the courts put an electronic tag round their ankle, which lets the police know if they're out of the house after their curfew. Doesn't always seem to work, though.
Why do people put on tags?
To try and keep them out of trouble, but it just makes it worse. They just breach it. He's on the tag. He's on the tag now, well, better be, but he ain't got it on.
Is it very common to be on a tag?
It is for me.
It's for everyone, isn't it?
Yeah.
You commit a crime, go get arrested, go to court, get put on tag. Can't be arsed with a tag because it's bullshit, so you fucking breach that, go back to court, then get a fucking few hours community service or more yacht, more tag, then you breach it again, then you might go to jail.
And then it's just one big circle.
Do the same again, and the same again, and the same again, that's it.
You go back to jail and you think, what the fuck am I doing back here?
Connor's still not been to school, but he's promised his mum he'll stay in and not get into trouble.
I mean, how does it make you feel when you see your mum, who's obviously very worried about it?
Should be good.
It makes you think that, does it?
Yeah. I want to fucking go out, man.
All my boys.
Fuck, I can't go out the fucking house. It takes fucking piss. That's why I want to go out. Chill. Oh, coppers are chasing them. Go, 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 go. Oh, shit. Coppers are driving on the path and shit. Fuck the police. Ah, oh, look at them. They're all mugs.
Who done that?
Me, by accident. Well, not by accident. Officers, you having a good day? Having a good day?
Quick! Watch out!
Twocking bikes is popular with the young lads around here. And the kids all know the alleyways and backyards like the back of their hands.
Bike. I think they know the second one's there. Yes, the walk straight. Over there. Straight in the kitchen. Put it in the house.
No, 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 no.
Just run it in the house.
Not in the house. Put it round. Open the shed.
Open the shed. Quick.
Spin it. Spin it.
Spin it.
With all my lift it.
Lift it. You're fucking lying.
Stop where there's a fucking brick. Fucking lift it. Over the brick you be.
Ram it up.
Bam, it's in.
Bam.
Yeah.
Get the key.
Yeah. Fucking hell, this drama, I want to go outside.
I only go out for 2 hours, I come home and it's like World War III. So once again, I come home after 2 hours and the garden's full of you utes. Yeah?
Yeah, sorry.
Yeah, but it's not funny, Colin, because it looks bad on me. Again, once again, I'm not going to go to Utah. But once again, the neighbours are looking bad at me.
Fucking hell.
Don't swear at me, Colin.
I'm a bad
one. No, you're not.
When drugs and crime are all around, it can be a struggle keeping your kids on the right path.
There isn't really any discipline for the kids around here. They don't listen to anything. Well, mine don't anyway.
Hi!
Dean's stepdaughter Leah is only 12, but she's been getting into some trouble at school.
Alfie! Yeah? Get bloody dressed.
Look. Tick, 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 tick. All day.
Oh, yeah, yellow one lot.
What's this? You got?
It's a report card. It's just if you like.
She's always on report.
Bad.
Because she can't be asked to behave.
I'm on report for 10 days.
I reckon they should put you on it for a bloody year.
They'll just give us ticks if we've been good that lesson, like, there.
You got lots of goods on there.
When she isn't on report, she doesn't get a good. Got your toast done, you can take it with you.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa! Don't eat on my video.
At least Leah's at school. It's been months now since Connor last went, and he's still hanging around on the estate with his mates.
The only time I don't worry is when he's in bed asleep.
And sometimes that can be 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning, depending on who he's hanging around with.
Have any of you seen Spin's dog?
No.
Even in the small hours of the morning, it can be pretty lively round here.
You want tag?
Yeah.
What time you got to be in?
I'm not beaching now, no.
What time you got to be in?
7 in the morning.
Eh?
What?
Yeah,
are you fucking mad?
I used to be a prolific shoplifter. So they lock me up, they keep me in during the day,
so... The shop's shut at night,
yeah, fuck it, just turn into a burglar, innit? Say crime don't pay and it does. Crime does pay. Crime pays better than a fucking proper job. That's if you got the balls to do it.
Fuck the police, see the police, don't chat to police. See the police, headbutt the police.
Connor's mates can see he's heading for trouble. And they reckon he won't like where it leads.
You cry, Connor, trust me. First time in jail, everybody cries. Ask anybody that's been to jail, they cry first time they go to jail. As soon as he gets arrested and goes up to court saying, you're going to jail, when he comes down, that's when you want to be filming it. He'll be on his knees crying, please, don't take me there. Trust me, I know what it'll be like. What I fuck? Connor, you're a lot younger than me. With him push up to me, so I was like, come on, you fucking bastard. You're too confident, mate. We'll see. It's a bigger thing than what everybody thinks.
Connor, get off and go out back.
You got your foot out. Go.
Tracy, jump in for us.
Okay.
Thank you.
Right, see you later. Try ringing me later.
Okay.
Back round at Dean's, Leah's been in trouble again, and not just at school.
I think she's had a couple of fights with kids. But it's silly, so just her mouth, just gobby. think she's, you know, like they tell her to do some, that she's just a bit clever with her mouth. But she's not like, I don't know. What is she actually getting in for, Dean?
Shoplifting, love. Well, why ask me? You was at the meeting yesterday, you fit cow.
No, I'm on about school. God's sake.
School is a behaviour. Not willing to work in class.
Yeah, not.
Not wanting to talk to the teachers. Listen with respect.
Him. Yeah.
Then out of school, she's pissing thieving.
Yeah, she went. She got caught shoplifting with one of mates at co-op.
She's grounded. As soon as she comes in from school, she has to go upstairs get in her jammers. She's allowed down for a tea, and then she goes back upstairs. Whatever homework she's got, she gets done, gets in her jammers, and stays in her bedroom, tidies her room, or whatever she has to do. That's what Claire said.
Yeah.
But we'll see. See how she gets on by the next interview. If it's not no better. She's got a long time in the bedroom till she leaves school, hasn't she?
Are you grounded at the moment?
Mm-hmm.
Tell me a bit what's been going on there.
I can't. I like it. I shouldn't have done it in the first place anyway.
I mean, I know why you've been grounded.
Yeah, but I don't really want to say it.
No. Is it something that you wish you never did?
Yeah, very, very, very.
Do you know why you did it?
No, I just, my friends do it, so I just copy it off them. I know I shouldn't have done it, and if I can go back, then I would actually not have done it. And I haven't seen my dad in a long, long time. I mean, like, I've texted him on Facebook and I've texted his girlfriend as well. But my mum thinks that now they've got the baby, they're not really cared about his other kids. Now that he's got his own baby. I'm sure he loves me. I'm sure he loves Harry and Danny still.
Obviously, you always want the best for your children, don't you? Try and give them a better life than you had yourself. I feel like I failed. I've just got this fear that he's gonna die young. That's how I feel about Connor. Whether it's on the streets or... I don't know.
Why'd you get into trouble, Connor?
Nothing to do. It's shit. That's not an excuse, yeah, but... ain't nothing to do. Must be good.
Oh, I'm knacking me.
Just wanna go to sleep. Get two blankets, go to sleep. Mom! Where's Mum? Let me in.
Ah, Skegness. The Ibiza of Lincolnshire. Dean's wife Claire is in Skeggy for a hen do and has got some time on her hands.
This is about the fifth time I've come to see the gypsy, and she's good. She's got a few things wrong, like, but no one's perfect, are they?
You know who I am, don't you?
Yeah, I come to you all the
you
time.
You know I won't keep my mouth shut, I'll speak the truth.
Yep.
Do you want one or two?
Two, please.
You got a long life.
Cool, yeah.
There's a new baby.
Yeah.
There's a new baby of a little boy.
Yeah.
There's another one to follow.
No. It's going for the snip soon.
It's not my fault. I see a baby girl.
Right.
She's coming in your life to make you happy. I don't see men beating you and treating you cruel no more.
No, not anymore.
You're strong-minded.
Yeah.
You give what you get.
Yeah.
There's good health, there's peace of mind, there's happiness for you. Stop worrying for me. Gypsy, I'll bless the day you've come to see me.
Thank you. She said I'm having another baby. I don't think so. No. She said I'm having a girl. No chance. He's off for the snip. If it's happened already, I'm going to fucking kill him.
Until Claire gets back, Dean's stuck indoors with the Littlins. And Leah, who's still grounded.
Yeah, that gypsy said that I was going to have another kid.
Fucking
and I was
not.
Like, no, I'm not. I said, off for the snip. And she started laughing. And she says, no, you're having a girl. I felt like saying, yeah, you fucking told me that
no
before.
Chance. No chance.
And then I'm out last night and I had to go to the toilet and I threw up. And Vera was like, you're fucking pregnant. And I went, am I? Fuck.
Fuck off.
I said, I'm not. I said, we've been careful. I was not going to get pregnant.
We have been careful.
We have very been careful.
Apart from one night.
Haven't we? Oh, yeah. I forgot about that night. I am actually late. Oh, fuck's sake.
Cold sweat? I feel like getting the knife out and chopping me nuts off my fucking sen.
Ah, fuck's sake.
Oh, yeah. Go take it.
You'll have to wait. I don't need a wee yet.
You don't want to know yet, do you?
No.
Go for a wee.
Ah, fuck
go
off.
Go for a wee.
I don't need
go
one.
Go for a wee.
That's not going to make me want a wee.
You're quite fertile, aren't you? You had sort of, you know.
Shit, Claire is.
Yeah.
Fucking Jesus. All I'd have to do is spunk on a hanky and fly to do the rest.
Jane!
It's true, though. I feel like an hamster in a cage. Every time we fuck, we end up with a kid. Well, yeah, I'll get you some in a minute.
Thanks.
Oh, you're being nice now, you want some?
What toilet?
Watch what?
You alright?
Yeah? Fine.
You're
not going to believe
this. I'll tell you in a minute. I'm off it. Can't find my fucking...
Oh! Never.
No, I'm only joking, I'm winding you up. I just said I'm going to go wind them up now. It's negative. I just thought I'd wind you up and give you an heart attack.
But accidents can happen, and neither of them want another mouth to feed.
See, people are new, like nine or ten kids. It's like, why would you want nine or ten kids?
I'll take that far.
I could just.
I think the most is about six, not nine or ten.
No, someone I know who's close has got eight kids. I think it's eight.
I don't think people get slated around here for having loads of kids.
No. It's just if they can't handle the kids, then, well, they'll get slated, just honestly. People don't really like them.
Why are you smiling? I saw you smiling. You think you're clever, don't you? Go outside and get in the car. Go on.
Today is Connor's last chance to get to school. He's had a letter, and if he doesn't go, they're going to come down on him and Jordan like a ton of bricks.
Well done, Connor. Bye. I'm not off you, you're not off.
Get in then, I'll go in.
Go on then, go in then.
He hasn't been for 4 months, so he's going to be a bit nervous. I understand that, I'm nervous for him, but still don't give him the right to treat me like he does.
Connor, what are you doing? Get your leg in the car, please. Yeah. Close the door. Stop being silly. Can't drive the door open. I hate that. I'm not having you calling me names. Now get to school. Are you going to school or are you now in that front? See, why have to put up noise? Not on nodding his head. Not that.
Fuck off.
Get in the car and go to school, Connor. You're causing trouble. You know what, Connor? You're not even coming in my house.
Good.
Fucking slag.
Go off in the fucking house.
I'm not a slag, Connor.
Fuck off.
You're finished at mine. Don't come near mine.
Just feels fucking numb.
After their pregnancy scare, there's no doubt in Dean's mind, 7 stepchildren and 2 of his own are definitely enough. Yeah. So he took himself off to the doctors for the snip.
Whoa, watch me, you're it.
See you later.
See you later.
No.
April, come here. Jack came around Daddy's legs today.
Hey.
Daddy's got Farley. Yeah, Daddy's
poorly. Yeah, I'm not very well, mate. Do you see it? The incision. No?
Where is it?
I don't know. I don't know where it is. I've got to wear these tight pants to open my nads up, so that, just wait a minute, so that, Jesus, how fucking small are these kegs? I've got to hold my nads up. Fucking spiders. I made a speedos, but fuck me. That's ridiculous, isn't it? They said the smaller and tighter the better, so if it holds you up, you're not getting any pains as much and it'll stop your balls swelling like footballs and shit. So,
feel better.
It does actually. Feels more supported. Not that I have much to fucking cover anyway.
No!
Being a parent round here is no picnic, that's for sure. It can be a struggle keeping your kids on the straight and narrow, especially if they don't see any point in trying too hard.
Connor, what do you reckon would make your mum happy?
Being good. We didn't quite catch that. Can you say it again, Connor? Because of the lobby. Being good.
And once you've got hooked on that cycle of drugs and crime, it can be difficult to get out.
I've been branded, haven't I? You get branded something. How can you change it? The only way you can change it is to move away.
But just like the steel that this town's famous for, people round here are tough. They keep fighting long after they might have fallen. They don't give up.
I'm British, you know, I'm like a staff, and I'll lock my jaw, and I'll make sure I just keep a grip of life.
Megan!
Ah! Oh, hey! Well, that's more than I needed to see.